ako mainiton nga mo abi-abi ug mudawat kaninyo nini atong gihimo nga talakayan ng pamahalaan tungo sa kaunlaran ng bayan. Mga higala, ang atong local government code, kung atong kainumduman, napirmahan na lagdaan pinisya isip usa ka batakang balaod isip Republic Act usa ka balaod noon ni atong October 10, 1991. Diba? Ang tungod ni ini, dunay Presidential Proclamation number 63 dated 1992 nga gipirmahan niya itong October 2, 1992 nga nagdeklara sa October isip usa ka bulan sa pag-celebrar sa local government code. And then, ang ikaduhang semana sa October, kada ikaduhang semana sa October, nagitawag na local government week.
We are falling now. And then on the 10th day of October as local government day sa tibuok nasod nga Pilipinhon sa pagkumimura o paghandom sa pagpasa sa local government code sa 1991. Okay. Atong isputan una, tubutay ako nga mulang minsaysay kung unsa ka may nungdanong buhusin limuha sa atong local government code. Ang kinatibukang limuha sa atong local government code, mo kining gitawag mag-angko nato ang local autonomy kun ang kaugalingnan nga pagdumala sa lokal na pagkagamahanan. Unsa man ang atong mga lokal na pagkagamahanan, probinsya, munisipyo o barangay. Wala mo tang sitio. Okay? Now, probinsya, munisipyo o barangay. Gihandong na makabot ang kaugalingnan sa pagdumala. Sa unsang pamagi, sumala sa tinguha sa local government code, gihandong na dunay pag-decentralize sa powers and function from the central government down to the local government unit. Decentralize. This is the essence of that local autonomy. Pag giunsan kini siya pagpakita o giunsan ni pagkabot kini pag-decentralize sa mga function, doon ay gitawag na devolution of powers. Gipasa gikan sa central government ang mga programa o ang mga proyekto sa gobyerno gikan sa local specifically sa agriculture na nakaroon ang pagdumala sa agrikultura diha sa atong mga kaprobinsyahan, kadakbayanan,
sa munisipyohan. That's one of the example the ang pag-deliver sa social services ang kagahon karon ana-ana sa local government units concern. Ang pag-plano, this is the very essence also, ang pagplano sa paglambo sa nagkadaiyan ng local government unit na anakaroon sa mga local development council. With that advent of the local government code, atong naangkon ang decentralization partially under our gaze. Doon na yung mga kalambuan o mga kadaugan na atong naangkon tungod sa pag-implementar nini ng mga balaod. Hapan, piliwala nini mga kadaugan, doon na usap kining atong ginatawag ng mga challenges kung mga pagsulay aron sa pagkabot sa tinud-anay na decentralization o local autonomy. Usa nga kagabahin sa estratehiya sa pagkabot sa local autonomy kining ginatawag na ito na de-bureaucratization. De-bureaucratization. Unsa kini nato mapadayag kung mapakita ang kining de-bureaucratization? Ang kalambigitan sa civil society organization mao kini ang malig-on nga kamatuoran nga dunay mahitabo nga de-bureaucratization sa unsang paagi. Kung atong kayong duman ka mo mga civil society organizations, ang atong local government code nag-provide nga sa local special bodies kung kanang mga kumitiba nga naa sa munisipyo, siyudad o probinsya, dunay himando nga representasyon gikan sa civil society organization, non-government organization. Hisbutan na ito ang Local Development Council. Ang Local Development Council nagmando nga dunay dili muubos sa 1/4 nga ratio. 1/4 representation of the civil society organization na mahimong miyembro diha sa Provincial Development Council, City Development Council, Municipal Development Council, Barangay Development Council. Kini nagpakita lamang nga ang kamahimong danon sa atong mga civil society organization isip kabahin sa pagpalambo sa atong mga kalungsuran o kamunisipyohan o sa atong kasyederal. So, inyong nini ang pinatibukan na overview o unsa kami hinungdanon ng atong local government code. Doon ay bagong programa sa gobyerno karon na bitawag nila bottom-up budgeting. Niining bagong administrasyon sa administrasyon sa bagong atong presidente, iyang gihatagan ang local government unit ug dugang pundo alang sa paglambo. Okay, dugang pundo. Sa kaso sa mga syudad, not less than 50 million pesos. Sa Dakbayan, sa Cagayan de Oro City o sa Iligan, 50 million is ang gihatag. Dili mo minus niya na. Sa mga component city, sama sa El Salvador, Hinoo, Cusamis, Tangub, Urquieta, Malaybalay o Valencia, mudawat kini og dili muminos og 30 million. Sa mga kalungsuran, mudawat og dili muminos sa 15 million. Unsaon ang kaminungdanon sa civil society organization in relation to the bottom-up budgeting or the grassroots budgeting program? May nang ganon. Kaya nga, no? Ang atong local government code nagmando lamang of 1/4 membership of CSO to the local development council. Di ba? Karon sa bottom-up budgeting, nimando na ang civil society organization should represent 50% of that body local poverty reduction action team. 50% of that composition gikan sa atong civil society organization. Be it accredited or not. Diba? Dili mo pasabot nga dili mahimong miyembro o dili mahimong kabahin sa pagplano niini o mahimong miyembro sa local poverty reduction action team ang dili accredited. Kaya the accreditation is not necessary to be a member of the Local Poverty Reduction Action Team. What is important unsa kamahinungdanon nga kinahanglan sa civil society organizations assembly nga ipatawag in one of these days within this month dili sa ang sudad mupatawag o usa ka asembliya sa tanang civil society organization aron nga mupili sa napulo ng mga personahe na mo representar o napulo. I don't know, indication sa Cagayan de Oro kung pila. Kaya kung unsa kagdaghan nun ang City Poverty Reduction Action Team, katunga ni ini magagikan sa civil society organization. So kung ang executive order ni Mayor mo disgot na doon ay pinatibok ang 30, so 15 ang katunga. Kung miingon tag na po 20, ang katunga is 10. So, gikan niya naman ang asimbliya sa tanang civil society organization, magpili ka mong representative para mahimong miyembro sa City Poverty Reduction Action Team nga muhimo sa City Poverty Reduction Action Plan. Plano kinisya nga maoy muhiya sa paggamit niya ng 50 milyones para sa Dakbayan sa Cagayan de Oro City. Tinana kami hinungdanon ang inyong partisipasyon.
Let's start with citizenship and volunteerism. Citizenship starts with a barangay. Our basic and fundamental premise is that each of us here, ladies and gentlemen, no matter what our socio-political circumstances, our positions in our respective organizations, sa atong atong gikuptan karon nga posisyon sa nagkadaiyan nato nga organisasyon, sa CSO ba, sa private sector or sa gobyerno, kita tanan first and foremost citizens of the republic and consequently are citizens of quote unquote mini republics, that is or that are the barangays. The same barangay that each of us will go home to at the end of the day, diin kita manguli karon, and the same barangays diin kita muuli as we bid farewell to our respective careers at the twilight of our years. Bisan kuno kita asa na karon nga hutong, asa na ang padulong sa atong tagsa-tagsa kagipadulngan, mubalik gayon kita at the end of the day sa atong tagsa-tagsa kabarangay. Citizenship is ownership. Panag-iya sa usa ka identity of being a stakeholder of public corporations. Unsa kini mga public corporations? These are the local government units, the province, the city, the municipality, and the barangays. The barangays are the basic and primary unit of which we are from. Citizenship, as we understand also, confers rights and privileges na yung mga katungod nagi-confer ka na to because we are citizens of this country and we are citizens living in the different local government units. And in the same way, that citizenship also confers duties and responsibilities. Dahil atong mga katungod, aba naausap kita'y mga duty o mga tulubagon. Therefore, citizenship must not be construed only and exercised by the mere casting of vote. Nakabutar man ko, mabutar man ako, na-exercise na nako ang ako ang katungod o akong obligasyon sa pagka-citizen. Rather, it must be actively exercised in all other areas and levels of our democratic systems, institutions, and processes. Active citizenship then calls for participation and contribution. Ang aktibo nga pagka-citizen sa usa ka nasod, sa atong local government unit, nagatawag sa atong aktibo nga partisipasyon sa mga gimbuhaton sa atong tagsa-tagsa, kagigikanan nga barangay. It also calls for vigilance and volunteerism for the benefit of the community and our country. Now, how do we understand, in this context, the idea of volunteerism? Volunteerism connotes doing something by choice. Wala ikaw pugsa apan imo nga gihimo. It is doing something by one's own free will, driven perhaps by a deep sense of duty, deep sense of responsibility, moral or spiritual fulfillment or obligation, perhaps the positibo nga feeling, pagbati of hope, compassion, mindfulness for the welfare of others, or sa giingon pa ni Abraham Maslow, gihimo nato para sa tuang self-actualization. Voluntarism is done or undertaken not for financial or material gain, nor will it only benefit oneself. So mag-ingon kitang voluntarismo, wala maghuna-huna sa unsay mubalik nga kun sa business pa ROI, return of investment. Gihimo nga walay kapin kabubuton. The barangay also as defined in the local government code of 1991 provides a forum diin ang collective views sa mga katawhan ma-express, ma-crystallize o ma-consider. And finally, the barangay provides a forum for amicably settling disputes. Now, by the latest count, there are over 42,048 barangays now in the country. Matag usa ga exist as I may quote unquote mini republics. Mura pud siya og republika in a sense. Ngano man? It has distinct territories, nasa kaugalingong teritoryo, naay kaugalingon nga population ug naay iyang kaugalingon nga pangagamhanan. In fact, dinhi sa barangay nagmingle ang tulo ka branches sa atong pangagamhanan, atong lantaon. Our basic and primary unit, which is the barangay, are organized by statute, by Republic Act 7160, equipped with the fundamentals of the three branches of government. One, ang usa ka sangay sa gobyerno, ehekutibo. The executive functions are exercised in the barangays. Ang ikaduha, sa pikas, ang legislative functions is also exercised in the barangays and discharged by the sangguniang barangay. And to some extent, but with limitations, of course, judicial functions exercised by the lupong tagapamayapa. But unlike the national and other subnational level counterparts, such as cities and municipalities, there is a mingling of the functional role of the punong barangay as chief executive. Sa national, naay separation of powers, di ba? Sa executive, ang nagapangulo, ang presidente sa atong republika, sa judiciary, ang chief justice, o dito sa tuang duha ka branches sa legislature, ang presidente sa senado, o ang speaker sa House of Representatives. But when we go to the primary and basic unit, nagmingol ang functional role ngadto sa usa, ang kapitan. Nili ang kapitan, ang punong barangay. Sorry. A very unique position barangays have in our republican democracy ang gitawag o barangay assembly. By legal mandate, it is the highest governing body, supposedly the highest governing body of the barangay. Diin, ang mga miyembro ng residente can ventilate, makapadayag sa ilang contempt or affirmations over the performance of their elected representatives. Dinhi usab sa barangay assembly, mahimo nga mapaminaw o mapapasar. Hear and pass upon the semestral report of the sangguniang barangay concerning its activities and functions. Finances, and in a unique setup, it is also vested, adunay kagahom ang barangay assembly, it is vested with the legal authority to exercise the essence of direct democracy.
Here, unsa ang mga basic na services nga naa sa barangay. Kay dili tanan nga serbisyo sa gobyerno tulo bagon sa barangay. Dunay mga serbisyo nga o function nga naa sa syudad o sa munisipyo. So, para lang may buo nato, unsay atong gi-expect nga dapat serbisyo niya sa barangay. So, agricultural support services, no? which include planting materials. So, naana sa barangay, health and social welfare, of course, because the barangay is the front line. So, the health and social welfare services na nag-include sa maintenance of barangay health center of daycare center. So, ideally, all barangays must have at least barangay health center and a daycare center. Then, services and facilities related to general hygiene and sanitation, beautification, and for Cagayan de Oro City, solid waste collection. Notice nato, lately, we had, it's a problem, really. It's really a problem on solid waste. But can we blame, usually atong reaction, blame the city government? Have we done the question, the very big question, have we done our part? Because solid waste management starts at home. Of course, the maintenance of the Katarungang Pambarangay as a Murasya og it's a judicial system, but it's not really a judicial system because it's an executive function. No? Ang Katarungang Pambarangay, all of us know heard or no heard about Lupong Tagapamayapa. It's in the barangay para makatabang pagdiklag sa ato ang mga kaso in the court. Ano ang mga sources sa income? Dapat po natin may bawaan, no? Sources sa income. Ang barangays, autorisado sila nga mag-generate of income from taxes and of, or on stores or retailers. So kamo, kung may mga tindahan, taxable na siya. And the barangays is authorized to collect taxes with business establishments with receipts of 50,000 or less, no? Then other service fees or charges for the use of barangay properties or facilities. For instance, naigwapong multi-purpose hall, pwede na siya magpasa og barangay resolution, parkilahan, so that the barangay can earn income. But it should be properly receipted. Okay, kung wala, basig dili na dito sa coffer sa barangay paingon. One is the kani clearance, barangay clearance. So use kani gyud nagwa-collect man gyud ang barangay sa aning fees. So this will add to their income. Fees on kaning mga pangsabong, fighting cocks or cockpits and cockfights. Pero gidiskar dili man siya pan kanang mga manok ba nga para pangsabong, that is taxable sa barangay. Fees or charges in places of recreation with admission fees. Okay? Nangatawa man mo sa sabong, manok, pangsabong. Katong manok na pangsabong sa kalaha, wala to siya fees. Fees or charges for billboards. Now, in Cagayan de Oro City, kita na to, daghang kaing billboards. No? Along, especially in the main roads, national roads, national highway, that is taxable. The barangay can impose tax. Okay. Neon signs and others, other outdoor advertisements. Toll fees or charges for use of any public road. So it's authorized. Huh? Toll fee. Pero, of course, it's not a, that is not, it's a general, ano, nga gi-allow sila, pero subject to certain provision also. Dili sa pwede nga, sirahan na sa kuan kay mag, dapat mag-toll fee. There are certain terms and conditions to be followed also. Let us go now to some important points in the election. So, kanun sama na, we know, October 28th, it's a Monday and it's a holiday. Very, very near. No? Dol na kayo. Mag-start ang election period, nag-start na atong September 28th and it will end on November 12th. That is why November 28th, katong carrying of firearms, kung naatay mga firearms theory, it's not allowed, it's prohibited. So, unsay traits kun ang qualities of an ideal. Ang isang namumuno ay hindi lamang dapat matalino, wala gitong ingon nga, hindi lagi itong kuan lagi nga, read and write atong i-condemn. Dapat siya ay mahusay na matino pa. M stands for modelo sa kalinisan at sa pangalaga ng kaligasan. It should be a model. Cleanliness. Siya ay nag-una-una ng segregation sa basura. Dili kay siya lang tingin, ay, mag-segregate mo, siya wala. A. Alerto sa oras ng peligro. So, talking of disaster preparedness. Dili kay niya una-una sa kapitan, huwag kawala. Biyaan niya iyang kuhan. Parera sa kapitan sa barko, una siya ambak, no? Laging nakahanda ang mga gamit. So, dili ang iyang gamit lang, ang dili di pasabot iyan niya. Laging nakahanda sa community, sa iyang constituent. H, mahu-H. Hanip. Hanip sa hanap buhay. Pasabot, bani, na siya'y way sa livelihood, means of living to improve the quality of life. Nagbigay ng pagsasanay na technical, naglaan ng livelihood programs, tumutulong sa, emphasis, ako ning hidugang-aning, tumutulong sa pagparehistro ng mga kasambahay. O, iyo, una sa servisyong palipunan. Subok sa kapayapaan at kaayusan.
Kamu kayo, you are the agreed party, you may in a form of query or you may lobby that through the DBM because as you said, the ILG through the DBM. Okay, as far as we know, we are not aware of that case. Whenever, if para mas mapadali nato siguro, mapasaka nato ang usa ka reklamo kung or clarificatory baka or reklamo ngadto sa DBM.
Okay.
State the facts of your case.
Next year,
the concern is about the topic ng Bureau of Division. Now, our NGO has been working with the LGUs, the local LGUs, the barangays, with the National Youth Commission regarding youth programs. Ang experience namo is the monotonization topic, the spirit of monotonization cannot be engaged in the barangay because in the absence of the development plan of the barangay that is concerned. Now in this case, because we elaborated in me what are the functions, what are the functions of the barangays in order for them to develop development plan and development program. Now question, the question is, kay umaabot ng eleksyon. Now, does the department regarding after the election once nominated to streamline for the introduction of new business possibilities in order to get to come up with the development plan.
It's a normal manamo ginahimo na sa DILG. After the election, we have a training for all local officials. The basic, no, kanin among discuss na to ron, part dito. Now, talking of the barangay development plan, the city government, we have a program, but we will implement that after the election. We will update kung nai update barangay, the all barangay development plan of the barangays. Of course, it's the barangay that will prepare, but we will steer sa barko pa among paano na nga para mo-move sila. This is in partnership with the City Planning and Development Office of the city. So, rest assured that we will go into that, a massive updating of Barangay Development Plan by the BDC. Kaya na may BDC nga i-organize that. But we cannot do that now. That will be done after election, that perhaps December or January.
Our observation for the Cagayan de Oro barangays, only very few NGOs and barangays has that development plan. The structure of the barangay organization is directed towards a very
Thank you, sir. We assure you that it will not happen in this time. Not this.
Thank you.
We will correct whatever mga kakulangon, no? We will try, we will do our best.
Youth, women, so I hope na mas pinag-alaman siya sa budgeting na sa God, na ay human disability, sa kabataan barangay, na ay youth disability, para dilitin niya lang siya sa 0.5 na ako sa persons with disabilities. So, no? But my other question is, how much is the maximum amount na ma-spend sa isang kandidato sa barangay? Kailangan, may ita kayo kong ehersito, nabisto siya, nagkakupay siya gasto, pero may out siya. So sa barangay, na yung maximum?
In relation to the first information, you said it's not a question, no? Information na lang na bahin-bahin ang 1% for the elderly, for the PWD, and then all of those sectors have PWDs. And then, supposedly, katong mga sectors, dapat ang PWD, PWD lang. Okay, now, we will take note of that observation, sir, and as a matter of, we are doing our recommendations after this forum. We'll be consolidating our recommendations, and we will relay that to respective agency concerned, particularly on DSWD and the DBM. The DBM has that authority to formulate that guidelines as far as this utilization is concerned. Thank you, po. At as to the second concern, which is the how much is the amount per voter that ang kada kandidato is allowed to spend? We don't have that information, sir. But at any rate, we will be working hand in hand with COMELEC to come up with the voters education for UNDAO or the like. Probably amoning mahimo on the air na lang siguro sa radio. We as much as possible, sir. Whenever kung nanatay information ni ani. Ato kanang mas share ngadto sa atong ginabag-ang katawhan para magayra nato. Okay, daghang salamat.
Would it be proper for DILG, city or provincial office to at least monitor barangay as to whether or not they really have conducted barangay assemblies and honest to goodness barangay assemblies? Because I for one have so many concerns about barangay, one of which is this having a barangay which is raised to free barangay. Sa DILG, pwede yung upa na bulikuron ng mga barangay. Hindi ko rin
pleasure.
Okay. Ako na lang mo to ba kay regional level man ang I think it concerns with the ILG. So being at the regional level, ma'am, wala nagkulang ang department in issuing the guidelines on how to conduct the barangay assemblies. Because as provided for in Chapter 6, Section 397 of the Local Government Code, mandates the barangay assembly actually twice a year. Now, for that purpose, Memorandum Circular 260 dated I'm not sure of the Proclamation 260. It's not Memorandum Circular. Presidential Proclamation 260 mandates the conduct of the Barangay Assembly every March 3rd, Saturday of March, and second Sunday of October of each year and thereafter. Now, ang naitabo, in every pag magpadangat na siya a month, less than a month, magpagawas kami yung circular mandating all provincial governors to inform to direct their punong barangay to conduct the barangay assembly. Tanawa, ang doon natay hierarchy of local government units. The governor being the supervisor of the mayor has that direct supervision over the mayor. And the mayor has the direct supervision over the punong barangays. Okay, what does it mean? Doon ay direct supervision nga kung unsay pagabuhaton sa punong barangay, madirektahan siya sa city mayor kung unsay buhaton. Along that line, ang among circular o ang kamanduan gikan sa DILG sa pagpatuman sa provision sa local government code, gipaagi nato sa governor, sa city mayor, ngadto dayon sa punong barangay. Karon ang pagtuman niini incumbent na sa punong barangay. Now, granting, ingon ka nga kung mahimo mamonitor within. As a matter of fact, tulo na ka barangay assembly akong naapilan sa barangay Balulang where I am a member of that assembly. Last three barangay assemblies dito jud ko ma'am. On the third attendance ako, I was invited being the ERD. The first two, I was invited. Awa ko ma-invite, pero I was there. As to the question sa tinud-anay nga pamaagi sa pagbarangay assembly, there is that gathering, yes. Pero kung sa tinud-anay, depende na karon sa nangapili nato nga barangay official. I'm not saying that the barangay that I attended to wala mo follow. No, wa ko moingon ni ana. But the point is, kung unsay imong gustong mahitabo, dapat tuwa ka dito. Aron mapadayag nimo kung unsay imong gagustuhan. When I was there, I did express my intention kung unsa unta'y mahitabo nini maong barangay assembly. And I openly did that. So, karon, I think ni ana gid ni sa atong civil society organization. Kay ngano, di barangay assembly kung dili tawagon sa kapitan, dunay katungod ang upon written petition of at least 5% of assembly members sa barangay. 5% of assembly members nga mo petition nga magkanda kamo og barangay assembly. You can do that. Kay it's only the kapitan or the punong barangay who has that authority to call a barangay assembly. Or upat sa iyang members sa saguniang barangay. Pwede na siya ipatawag. Ang upat nga barangay members, pwede mo patawag. O ang 5% of the membership of the assembly in that barangay. And what is the basis? Ang basis niya na motong registry of inhabitants diha sa barangay nga makuha ninyo diha sa inyong barangay secretary. Pangutana, doon na ba'y registry ang barangay secretary sa inyong inhabitant sa barangay? Which will be the basis of that 5%? Mausa na akong pangutana. While we are in the DILG trying mga 5 or 7 years ago, doon na kami programa nga Registry of Barangay Inhabitants. Tanang barangay sa tibuok Pilipinas among gipangayuan og listahan sa tanang lumulupyo sa iyang barangay. In the event that there are addition or deduction to that list, tulubagon kini sa barangay secretary. Pangutana na sa inyo karon, pangutana saan mo, gituman ba na sa barangay secretary? Tungod sa kadaghanon sa 42,000 plus barangays, dili na ko na matubag kung unsa ka matinud-anon ang pagtuman ni ining amaong provision. We are there as a third monitor. We shall serve ourselves as the third monitor, being partners in the governance sa barangay. Okay? I think kung doon ay kadugan si Jane. But...
Okay, salamat kay ma'am. Actually, muna naging naingon nga kung walay complain na tulay kaso. So, this is the very essence of this consultation, to let you know what are the things that supposed to happen in the barangay. Now, para ninyo na nanay, mga concern ninyo nga kung wala magigikanda ko barangay assembly, that could be a ground for negligence of duty on the part of the punong barangay and the barangay official. So, you can file a complaint. The monitoring per se is there, pero in the absence of any party nga nagkuana na malisod, the DILG's role, we cannot motu proprio file a case against the barangay officials, nor we have the direct disciplinary authority over the barangay. It has gone through certain process. However, kung namoy mga complaint, you have to put that in writing para po ma-address po na siya whatever you do, through persuasion, because we, ang among ginamit is persuasion eh. Persuasion lang, reminder to the barangay officials, these are the rules, there are their function. So, inguna na lang siguro, make it in writing, but we assure you that we do monitor. We monitor.
Okay, as far as that dissemination information campaign, on our part with the ILG, we had gone through, with that advocacy campaign, ma'am, we did in our part, but to some extent that the barangay should do his part to announce that. I must agree with you, and I should agree with you, nga nahitabo na siya, kay medyo, I even opened that as one of my issue when I attended. Sige, ma'am. Noted.
Actually, ako question si sa final na ako ni Sir Sanjay sa Ma'am Rimo Kisunan. So the first question is just verification, sir. I am po Simpron, Chairman of the Board and President of the Motorola Federation of Kenya University, which composes 3,000 members here in Kenya University. I would like to have this question about the City Power Generation Team. So, we are more concerned about the most rarely marginalized sector than most of us are living under the poverty line. So, we are very concerned on how we could do for our fingers. You see that there will be a will be created. So, I just want to be clarified. Considering our numbers, I think we will have that representation, sir. And secondly, ma'am, about this barangay assembly, to be fair to those who are not involved, who are still aspiring to fight the leadership of barangay chairman, I want to know, you said just recently the barangay assembly should be prepared because this is election time, because and it can be so sorry to run it.
2016, ingon naman, no? October 13, that second Sunday of October. In the absence of any written amendment to that proclamation, there is no prohibition. More so that in the COMELEC resolution, it's not a prohibition. It's in the manner how they conduct the assembly. And in fact, during the meeting of the Liga ng mga punong barangay, ng mga barangays, I shared that wala pa ng verbal instruction. I told them the conduct of General Assembly is a go because it's a law, it's a proclamation, but it is in the manner how you conduct yourselves during the assembly. I caution them on that, and that can be a basis for premature campaign. It's a basis. So, wala tayong may mo na, sir, because there is no ano. There is, although the verbal. Nagin ako, in the absence of written, I cannot also give verbal lang po na ako an advisory to defer. But if they will insist, there is no prohibition. Mag-advise lang po nga verbal. So, dili. Wala tayong kuhan because we are the government of laws. No? Dili pwedeng atong opinion, atong yan. Second, the first question on the CIPRAT, ayun na yung proseso. For 2014 projects, the past, for the 2014 projects under the bottom-up budgeting, the process started in 2012 December. Ingon naming natabo, for the 2014 projects, the NAPSI conducted the Civil Society Organization Assembly. It's the NAPSI's role. The ALG was there, because the money for the assembly was released to us, but as to the conduct, wala ni, dili mi pwede manghilabot. We've given instruction, di manghilabot. So, yung naning netabo, gipatawag ang mga CSO in the city, although there mga concern ginagmay ato, then among themselves, they elected kinsa ang ilang representative to the CIPRAD. Kato equivalent. I've heard, I know it's 10 from the other side. I don't know. Because wala pa mang kuato sa Cagayan Oro City. That's for 2014. For 2015 project, the budgeting process, the process will start by December or November this year after the election. So what will happen? We will now again conduct an assembly of all civil society organization, the basic sector, will again conduct going through the same process. You will elect your representation. But doon ay na siya yung mga specifics dito, dun ay 4Ps, doon na po yung specific dito nga kinsa po. Dili po nga bisan si kinsa lang ang mapili, no? So, we will go into screening of kinsa gyud to po mo attend kay naman po yaban nga wala siya gidala nga grupo nga basic sector to lang siya dito bogus. I want to be frank, no? So this time we will see to it that those who sit down during the CSO assembly for the election of the representation to the CIPRAD, we will try our best to come up with the real, the legal, whatever na dapat siya gyud nga represent. And we will do that by November and December, sir.
Now, this is just a clarification of what you said a while ago about the position. In the appointment of Puno Barangay, the 4th degree instead of 4th degree. But as I've read in civil service law, it is just nepotism is only 3rd degree. Is there any differences between effective appointment elective appointment and
administrative appointment? The rule for barangay officials for kuan is covered by another law, local government code. So dili lahi itong sa civil service because they're covered with a different administrative code of the Philippines. So lahi siya. So very specific within the fourth the civil degree of consanguinity and affinity. So an example of that is at pag-umangkon na anak sa imong igsoon, that falls under within the fourth. So na siya system pag-determine, i-branch out man na siya, i-tracking na siya, no? So, fourth na siya. Different ang nepotism for the civil service, under the civil service code.
We came from the society in which Mr. Kovic had been as a student, we conducted research and assessment about the compliance of the government, about the established act and policy of the government. You have stated a while ago about the cleanliness and identification of barangay, and it is under the heading RA9003, which is the solid waste management. And as we conclude, and based on our research and assessment, there is no compliance, especially the MRF of the barangay. Is that allowed to be revoked? Is that allowed nga kanilang hindi siya makomply sa isang kanilang kuhan sa kanilang isang kabarangay nga kanilang kuhan na siya nga kanilang requirements sa Republic Cafe? As a public officers and employees of the government, we are mandated to act the highest of our responsibility, utmost responsibility and dignity, active public wisdom, justice, honesty and efficiency. So, is that allowed?
Okay, thank you. Thank you for that. So, kita na to, ama to mga yun. Talking about MRF, under the law, kigundiha nga, each barangay will establish an MRF. However, let us be realistic also. No? In the case of urban barangays, the case of Cagayan lang, one urban barangay, upat ka, blocks. And these are commercial districts. So it would be very impractical to put up an MRF within. So what we are suggesting with a clean law, no, because we will go into a massive advocacy on RA9003 after election. Okay. To tell you honestly, I'm still 2 months old in this city. No, so we were doing things right. We will correct things, no? So, what we are suggesting is a cluster of barangays for MRF because it's costly also. So, tanaw na to in a case-to-case basis. In the case of Gusa, nasla MRF, dako man sila area, lapasan, they can have each one. Pero diri sa mga urban areas, we cannot expect also 100% nga nag-individual, pwede sila mag-cluster sa MRF. Kung practical siya, pero kung dili, kaya na naman po yung mga junk store, pwede na po nga wala MRF. Kaya direkta naman siya paliton. What is basic lang sa 9003, nga kala dapat i-comply is the segregation at source segregation para sa taong atong kwan ko, reduction of waste nga. Ang ihakot sa syudad, paingon dito sa landfill, residual waste na lang. So katong pwede nga ma-recycle, pwede nga ma-compost, pwede to be done at the barangay level. So, sanction, yes, RA9003 speaks of sanction. Mulagin na, it's a process. We have to go through due process. Dili ata arbitrary po na mukuan nga. Because they have not complied. We have to prove that they have not complied and there should be complainant for that matter.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Sorry, Gigay, pero last na nato si sir sa atong kwan.
Excuse. Gamay lang, sir, ha? Ma'am, could we have a copy of your result para mahimong knowledge product namo sa atong LGRC? We will keep in touch with you and then Secretariat is taking note of that. Ha? Could we have a copy of that result so that it can form part of our knowledge product for our Local Governance Resource Center? We have the Local Governance Resource Center at the ILG. Thank you.
Basically, I just express a comment, a challenge, and a request, basically. With the presentation of the role, nag-emphasize tayo sa lahat ng pagkakaroon sa ILG. Nag-emphasize po sa i-expect na po sa katong katawag dito sa katong profesyonel sa barangay, plus na-express na sa katong presidente sa ILG. Meron po lang kanila ang tanan. Pero ako lang siguro, magkakalita na ito ba? Nasa pala ko sa kapatutan ng ating kapagod. Na ubiingon na ang kapitan, chairman, kasi ako nagsasya na ito, ang maliwit na ito, pili ng tao-tawag na ito, kapitan. chairman o chairman o ng barangay. So, katotohanan ng sa kumala, o kaya, ang chairman, katotohanan ng barangay sa hindi. Pero kung hindi siya, upang sa kagawa, pero kung hindi siya ng lima, 5% sa barangay sa hindi. At ito, karoon, hindi kaupati, kaupati. Kaya sa inyo yung chairman, kaupati siya, upang kagawa, kaupati sa 5%. Ini is kung hindi siya magpatawag ang upat. Kung hindi magpatawag ang upat, 5%. So kung di ba sa upat ko nagkaka, kung hindi kita ang matawag, kung hindi ito nakuratan sa atin, chairman, doon lang tayo tawag ng ulipon. Bayan yung kausin ko sa kanan ng ulipyo, pwede magparikon para kayo siya. At kung nagkakulong, hindi ko pinisarap na siya. No? So siguro ako kung lang, wala ka kapalo, dito sa barangay ng Development Council. Siguro may patawag kita din, Riggs, kaya, as CSO, kaya pwede man na mag-initiate ka na po ang pagpatawag ni barangay ng Development Council. Ngayon din, dito tama, kung napangunan mo kagalitan o development plan ng mga barangay, magsukod sa ato ang rekomendasyon tungkol saan na sa ato barangay ng development plan. So, the only anything ang pwede mong pulis sa itong barangay niya, kita. Kita, kita na ang nakatulog. Muna siguro ang rason ini, na ayun o, is nakatulog ang nangyayin sa ako. No? Nakita ang mundo. So siguro, before election na may unta, forum, candidate forum. Kung asa mo mga barangay, request mo na. Kung asa mo mga barangay, pwede naman siguro kami ng mga organizations, kita ng mga organizations, kami na kami ng kami ng upat, manong kabarangay actually. No? Napinahanglan, mag-facilitate, mga barangay forum para sa inyong mga mudaga at karong eleksyon. Kami mag-agurla, ayun ang kami mag-sesa agenda, kami mag-sesa questions. Para makatulong kung sila mo. Request na rin lang, if ma-appili sa monitoring sa DALG, kung kinsa na mga barangay ang tunay active CSO participation, no? Nakahayagin ko siya sa best practice. Ano na yung example sa 42,000 na ito, guys? Sa akin kong na-mention na, na kung magsugod sa barangay na kaiwan or development, wala ba ang naso? So, bisan sa gamay ang barangay dito sa Cagayan, pwede siguro na masugod ng tunay. Kaya this forum, na pwede na yung before the election, sponsor by a CSO. Sabi ko, kamu tiro kinamos, pwede naman siguro sa kanila. No? Pwede wala. No? Nagbuha na natin. So pwede wala. And second request na, mamonitor sa na tinuod yun ang BDC na mag-create after the election. Yung mga kapatuloyan na lang nagkahimok sa utang na barangay. Yung tayo yung tinuod, well represented, recognized ang mga CSO sa kanyang barangay, na makastrengthen po niya dito sa SIPA. Kaya mura ko lang, nag-represent pa ba si William sa barangay so and so dito sa women representative sa SIPA. Si Farmer sa Basa, 24 barangay sa Bukit, mura ko lang siya nag-represent dito sa Farmer sa Basa dito sa SIPA. So siguro, wala na ang request na maki-appeal dito sa itong monitoring sa city. Thank you.
Kaning GBM, we are really very active, no? Active partners in governance. Maning ginapangita na itong klase sa developmental, development-oriented. As to the proposal, it's a welcome move on the part of the CSO. Maning gusto na itong, we have to also with COMELEC on this matter, no? Okay, you know, election matters to the ALG, it's COMELEC. We will come in if it involves the incumbent. Okay. Second, katong sa BDC, yes, I can assure you, siguro, I'll just give 80% assurance. I cannot say 100%. But we will try our best to implement what is really dapat, not on the reportorial per se, functional on paper, but you cannot see in person. So that's the functional talaga siya na, we will do that. And we can do this with the cooperation, with your full cooperation. Along this line, akong i-ano lang po, challenge, there was a proposal yesterday, Manggod, nag-assembly me sa NGO, accredited NGO kagapon. Out of the 50, we have 30. So we accepted the 30 to become member of the CDC, although we need only 29. So naisa, so na. There's a proposal. This is a move to really to empower our people to come up with an kamo nga si ISO, maggrupo mo. So that pagilailasad mo, mag-complement, na-complementation sa inyong services also. No, dili mo mag-compete but to help each other. So inyo na na siya, we will not sausaw din na, it is just a suggestion for you to consider inyo na siya nga mo. But we can assist you. Dili lang sa Dublin, that matter.
It was founded a very single. It was actually so walang ibang saong pag-implement na matatawag ni pero namokay ni Nana. So basically private organizations na siya ma-veritize kung kita kayo na yung problem at ang masis na we do not know how to ano kayo. Ikaw pili ikaw magpa-restore sa pinag so walang din mga rules and regulations. Ang isa sa mga activities is about the waste management. And I invite the across leaders and even delegation, we invited some local government officials to attend the seminars done by ganang mga video, kung ano yung nakawa pa, dugay din sila sa mag-campaign sila consultants in our nation. Next is, our family is a victim of what the Dominican society in Bukat is a barangay. Nagtatanin na yung family kayo. Pagtutanin mo nga, may something wrong, yun lang na magpunin pag-isen at file. At upang isang mga barangay officials, at upang sa barangay officials, nagtatanin mismo ang tao nga, kaumahay mo, tanggang ang iyong mga pag-ibarating na salalan, magpap, pinamatay, o pinabot ang barangay officials. And then, ang result na kami mong iyon nga, is magpakahinomin. Nalinisod na siya, and there were cases na nangyasuko ko sa inyo sa ila, mag-o siya sa inyo, like, oh, pinabot ang iyon. And then, nainyamot na rin ang case na rin, and then, ang police, kaya di ba siya magbawas, kung siya magigaro, magkakas siya pinayang arm na rin. So, during that time, hindi siya magbawas, okay, okay, kami nga lang ang mag-return, di ba? So, that's one issue na. And then, how long, inyong barangay for any, di ba? Ano mo mga and then, kung inyong pagmating mo, mag-raise man ang pag-ay, for how many years, many have been complaining. So, more na siya, mana siya, kung sa ito ka, mawala na siya, more na siya, mawala na siya, trend ba, mo, hindi yung personality and your person, pero nobody was able to do something about it. So, kana na ako, next month is about something in my grad back. I want, tanong ka to, uro ka to siya, we have a rules of traffic and then sa KDNS. Okay. So, nag-anumi kay sa amo po, sa ako po, sa construction ng po, nila, ako na yung trabaho. So, di ko mapunod at ang ali, pre-planting ka. So, in our organization, we're able to get the solicitation na yearly, mapil ang mga official na nandang nag-apil sila. Ang problema na po, ma, pag mag-pre-planting, di walang protection, nag-ihatag sa government for the traffic mo na. Pag humanin mo ka nyo, pag-picture ko mga patay, ganyan naman, naamay mga baka, mga sa kahoy, ganyan. So, kung ano na, ito hindi ko pwede sir, isa ito nag-open na, nalitre ko nga, pwede lang ko na lang ko kayo, this would be a kayo nga, kung encourage me sa inyo sir na, this would be done with it twice a year, na hindi mo ang strong work na inyo hindi ko ang nakabigay. Kaya nga nung, ulit, rito ka sa barangay, nalitahan ka sa tao, sometimes ang hindi gusto, you would pose as a threat. Pero na, may ato ka as ang anin na din niyo, and then kurabag sa lalahanan, and then if this is ordinance like that, you can't take it. Example, how come na ang sitbak na 2 meters niya sa lalan, we should not be used as a private tindahan, a private parking area for a person, na nakapos of traffic, and then you could see about it, who is the one in charge na any seat box magamit parang ganun ba ang talan and then who is in charge also for na kung ngayon po lang kayo ay mo gasto sige magpangkam magawa ko na rin irrigation pero mabungka
Salamat kay no, regarding that special issue, can we talk it over? Ito lang, no? Then, as to your suggestion that we'll have much of this, motong akong gi-encourage lagi if not with DILG alone, pwede man kamo ang organize among yourselves as CSO para ano, para ma-empower yun, gikan sa inyo, then you can invite us. Kay lahi man god pod og kanang kami gyud murag ano ba para ko free willing discussion for the development of the city and the barangay. Then kung naay concerns ma'am regarding mga barangay official, please feel free to visit our office or even to call our office. Now we will deal on that, not necessarily a formal case because we can do little persuasion. Lakong imo lagi na ang amo mangod sa DLG, dili man mi kami ga-discipline, but we can do a little reminder, persuasion, yan ni, magpadumdum kay mas may mangod na napoy someone or outside nga nakapag-remind sa itong mga barangay officials so, kung sagid ang ilang mga responsibilidad. Not necessarily going into a formal case kay makuan madugo man sa siya god. Okay, so we thank you for that and can we talk?
Sa 2 hours, again, in behalf of the regional management, daghang gihing salamat sa atong pag-anhinog. Masinsya lang yun kung we don't have enough time to cater all the questions and suggestions. Rest assured, you may go direct to the DILG City office. We would further recommend nga sa DILG City office gyud kay she has the jurisdiction over the Cagayan de Oro affairs. Though we at the regional level, we can provide some technical assistance as far as the city DILG medyo manginahanglan sa Muntabang, but I do believe that our city director here is very able to really, she can, I'm suggesting, kayang-kaya niya ni Director Jane. Okay? Veteran ito eh. Fighter. Okay? So, we have categorized our cities into 4 areas. We have identified the issues and the gaps. And then, what are the possible solutions to that issues? And then, what is the critical next steps? And then, what are the determining accountabilities? Okay. Ganito. For the identifying the issues and the gaps and the challenges, we have identified that the formulation of barangay development plan is a must, and then allocation of budget for PWDs, and then the conduct of barangay assemblies monitoring, and then there was no effective dissemination of the conduct of the barangay assemblies. Okay, and then there there was an issue on the creation of CIPRAT, what is the criteria? And then there is the issue on nepotism, and then whether what should apply, the civil service qualification, the civil service, okay, or that one that is found in the local government code, or there is that presentation of the policy research on solid waste management by the MUST. And then we have, again, the barangay development plan formulation, which is promised by the city government. And then the specific clause in charge of the implementation. Okay. As part of the possible solution to that effect, that there is that plan formulation, and that the 1% of the PDWD should exclude among others, di ba? It should be exclusive to the PWDs. And then the DLG to monitor the barangay's assembly and sessions. And then DLG to conduct advocacy campaign in the 2014 projects of the BUB, which was conducted by NAPSI, which is for 2015, the DILG will conduct the CSO assembly na. Okay? And then for the barangay officials, it should be covered by the administrative code as far as appointed local official is concerned. Then barangay to establish an MRF And for the urban barangays, it should be clustered for the urban barangays. And then there is that call for a community CSO participation, meaningful participation of the CSO in the community affairs. And then there was that solution that the candidates forum may be conducted, shall be conducted as a matter of initial move of the CSO in the barangay in relation, in coordination with the ALGN and COMELEC, of course. And then for that candidates forum, and then encourage and confer with yun nga, with the ILG. Now, as far as the critical steps, we are visioning that that the BDC that should be organized would not just be in a paper, but for compliance purposes, but it should be a functional and meaningful BDC, Barangay Development Council. And then the planning and budget budgeting, yun nga, yung 1%. There should be a policy formulation to that effect, which we will recommend to, as I said kaganina, to the concerned agencies, to DBM and the SWD, as they are the agencies that are involved on this. And then strictly monitor the conduct of barangay assembly. We will do that. As far as I can remember, there was that issuance before by our late secretary, Robredo, that whenever there shall be sanction to those barangay, punong barangays who fail to conduct barangay assemblies. And as a matter of fact, we have reported that last two. And we are awaiting on, yun na nga, with the early demise of our former secretary, we are awaiting as to the continuity of that policy. So, hopefully we are looking forward to this, and through this forum, we will provide the output of this atong forum. And then for Republic Act 90003, the Solid Waste Act, a copy of that research should be provided to our local governance resource center for that to be shared to all LGUs and to all other concerns who may visit to our website. We have the local governance resource center, and then the CSO partnership and the BDC organization is really the critical one. And then with that last point of our lady participant here, that some concerns may be directly conferred with our city directors. Now, for the determining accountability for the BDC, the plan might be formulated. And then for the barangay elections, there should be a meaningful pagpili ng mga barangay officials. Okay. Constituents awareness, communities, community fora, and then the barangay officials and communities involvement. And that organization of the City Poverty Reduction Action Team, which is composed of the 50% coming from the civil society organizations, and then the City DILG with the City DILG and private sector hand in hand. Okay? So again, that's how it is to be in these activities this morning. And I hope na atay meaningful. Is there? Na siguro. At least we had started this, and definitely we will be doing this again, not only on the next local government day, because today is the local government code day, no? So we are looking forward to another things like this, a collaboration between the civil society organization and the national government agency. Daghang salamat sa inyong pagtubag sa atong tawag o sa inyong pagpagkabana. Daghang salamat sa atong tanan.